In this particular video, I will share you the workflow that is in ProBench, especially the actors that are involved in ProBench. So before we do that, let's understand the three steps that ProBench does. The ProBench collects data. It automatically scores and does the scoring part of it. Also, analysis bit is available. And the third part that it does is create scorecard or dashboard. So in this diagram that you see on the screen, so it's a continuous process. So ProBench is often used by teams. So there's, you will find, so these are three different teams, depiction of it. They will fill in the data using some kind of an online survey tool that is created inside ProBench using templates. And then once we collect the data is stored in ProBench, and then you can use our data set feature to clean the data, to transform the data, or to apply the scores which are automatically created during the collection phase. And the third part of it is that each individual participant, in this case the team that participates in ProBench, gets a feedback report. So that's kind of unique about ProBench, is because we can help each client, each company, to get its own bespoke data that helps them to see where are they in the whole scheme. And it helps them to move forward, especially in sustainability or SDG. It's a very simple way of narrating the complete three-step process, and the specific emphasis are on the team that collects the data. So that's the reason I would emphasize on actors, because if I let you know who are the actors that use ProBench, that will help you understand better how the three-step process works. So let's talk about our client story. So our clients are typically nonprofit, think tank, or a rating company, especially in sustainability area. They do benchmarking or assessment. It could be any kind of assessment, from responsible investment to responsible cotton, access to nutrition, farm animal welfare, gender diversity, pay gap, things of that sort. So there are 17 SDGs. That UN has decided. So it can be ranging across. So here I've taken a picture of one of our, it's not our client's team, it's a representation of a client team. It has more, almost all the actors that require that use. So this is our client. And I will walk you through each person and what could be their roles and responsibility. As you can see, the person sitting in the center, this person is the leader of the team. This person is second in command, and rest are the team. I'll come back to the detailed role of it, but the important thing that you have to understand in terms of collection data is our client's client. Our client always do benchmarking in corporates. So this will be always company who participate in the client, in our client's benchmark or the benchmark they are conducting. So I've put different fruit here. Most of the company's names are often some fruit name. So they represent companies that accept to participate in our client. So these are the people who will be either inputting the data, or the data will be about them. Now, who puts in the data might differ. That I will walk you through three workflow. That's the main agenda of this video. But that's very important to know, that not only the team which are involved, but they are actually companies, and there will be a point of contact in the company, or there will be multiple departments who will be filling in the data. So it's not a one-time process. The data points can be anywhere from 100 to 1,000 data points that we collect for each data. That's the level of complexity the benchmarking has. So as I mentioned, we'll come back to the role. So I've given number to each person, starting from left to right to make it easy. This is one, this person is two, three is the leader, four is second in command, five and six. So the leader is program manager, kind of taking care of the entire program, under which the second in command is the project manager, the person who takes care of the team, communicate, helps them to mitigate any challenge or helps them to move forward. So the number two that is mentioned here, let's say that person is a reviewer. And number one is a client relationship. So you understand client relationship here because our client's client is a company. So you need someone to continuously speak and talk because there are multiple people involved and the complexities is there in the data collection process. So we need client relationship. Reviewer is someone who checks in the data, see if all the data points are correct or not. And analyst is someone who will do the analysis on the data collected, and data analyst is the technical bit of it. So that's that. So this is analyst, this is data analyst, project manager, reviewer, and client relationship. So far, so good. These are the three workflow. The first workflow is the benchmarking, where the data collection is done by company user. Then the data is reviewed by a reviewer. There can be a back and forth between data collection and data reviewer. That could happen. The second bit of it is once the data is freezed or the submission is done, normally it takes anywhere from 1 month to 3 months to collect the data based on the complexity of it. Then it is passed on to another process where the score analysis is done by analyst and the feedback report is created. Now in our case, because it is done in ProBench, most of this part is automatically done, but if you don't use ProBench, they might have to be do manually. And once the feedback report is done, it is given back to a company to benchmark them against other companies. The second workflow is assessment. In this case, the data is not filled by the company. It is filled by an analyst that's a part of our client. Normally it can be an in-house analyst and it can be an external team. Now, because we are in this point, so the role that I defined you initially, that role, there can be a possibility that one person can be performing a couple of roles. So a person can be a project manager or a project lead, but he or she can also be analyst or a reviewer. So it's not one-to-one mapping, it's a role that someone performs. So in this case, the analyst fills in the data on behalf of company. So the person can be filling data for multiple companies. Then they send it to company to review, seeing that this is what we saw in your website or this is the data we collected. Are you okay with it? If you have any feedback, so on and so forth. So that is done by the company. And then it is given back, the assessment is given back, and again the score analysis and the feedback report is done, it given back to the company. This is the assessment part. So the main difference between a benchmarking and assessment process in the workflow is that in this, the company is collecting the data, company fills in the data. In this, the someone else, an assessor, fills in on behalf of company. Now, I put the name as benchmarking and assessment just to distinguish it a bit, but it can be any process. The workflow is different from that person. There is something called a self-assessment, where the analyst configures the whole platform and companies opt in and they do self-assessment. A score is automatically created and instant report is generated. The user can see. The companies can see the data. So that's straightforward, a self-assessment. Now in terms of companies, because there are multiple users, there is a different workflow there. So there is a client relationship person who talks to the company, or it can be an analyst who talks to the company. So there is some company contact, the point of contact from the company who is the data owner, who make sure the final data is up to date and everything. But there can be different business functions from which he or she may be collecting data. So for a company, because of the complexity of the data and the data point, there can be many users from company. And it is outside the flow that I discussed. The internal flow or the assessment and the benchmarking flow is one flow, but there can be company can have its own flow of collecting data based on the different users they have. So it is the role. There can be multiple people or there can be single person in there. Now the workflow for each of our client is unique. There is some or the other variation. That's why the collection of data has a different way to it till the time the benchmarking report is created. The question that you have to ask is, who is collecting the data? As you have seen, there are many actors. How many steps are involved? As you have seen, there can be different steps involved in the process, and there can be combination of steps involved also, but it depends upon the client. But ProBench as a tool is very flexible to find the requirement as per your spec. And what are the timelines that you are looking for? So if you are looking for something where the clients put in the data and they want immediate assessment or something, so you might have to go for automated self-assessment kind of workflow. Or if you are looking for a benchmarking where collecting different companies, then you might have to go for the longer process, workflow one or workflow two. Thank you for watching. This is Vikram Shetty from 73bit.com. If you have any questions, you can contact us at hello@73bit.com or put your questions in the comments below. Thank you very much.